morning. Thanks for tuning in and welcome to Wednesday's session. The local share market will kick off with a gain of around 0.2%, according to where the SPY futures contract ended overnight. So it was a bit of a bumpy ride for the futures contract, to be frank. It was lower by as much as 0.33%, and it finished closer towards the upper end of its range. So not a bad performance from that perspective. But the one thing that you immediately ask yourself is, like, we've got the local contract up modestly, and that contrasts with some pretty punchy gains as far as Wall Street was concerned. So we had the NASDAQ up 1.5%, the S&P 500 rose 1.1%, hitting a new record high in the process. The Dow Jones was ahead by around 0.6%, and the Philadelphia Semiconductor Index, which is worth pointing out at the moment, given the heat that we're seeing where technology names are concerned, that index, having taken quite a knock a couple of days ago, seems to be making inroads into a recovery. So overnight it was up by around 2.1%. So there are a couple of important factors to focus on as far as US markets were concerned last night. So let's just look at the economic news of the day. So this was the February inflation report. So when you look at the headline numbers, the figures were hotter than what the market had anticipated. I won't bother going through the monthly moves. Let's just focus on the annualized numbers. So in terms of the headline rate of inflation in the United States, that came in at 3.2%. So that was higher than the 3.1% that the market was looking at, and a bit of a bump higher compared to the previous month. The core rate of inflation, so that excludes food and energy, it gives you a better sense of what prices are doing when you take out those elements, and that measure moderated from 3.9 to 3.8% in annualized terms. The market was looking for something a little bit lower, not by much, 3.7%. So now this brings us to the variant that the US Federal Reserve has been focused on over the course of the period since the pandemic. The reason being is that it's called the super core measure, and it basically strips out the housing element out of the core inflation number, and it gives you an underlying sense of what's happening with services. And that's because, you know, the lower rates, the stimulus, the inflationary environment of the last couple of years, it has seen elevated service prices that have been quite stubborn in terms of their pathway moving lower. And this is what the Fed has been quite focused on as a measure of where inflation is going in the future. And this is why we pay such attention to it. So the important thing is that this measure moderated more than what the market was looking at over the course of the last month, and particularly comforting, I suppose, is the progress made in annualized terms. And that was part of the reason that we have seen mixed outcomes when it comes to the response. But to be frank, the market has ignored the headline number and looked through that, and that's why you've seen the shares move higher to the extent that they have, and they have been helped by better earnings as well. So one of the features of Wall Street session last night was the outperformance of Oracle shares. So up by 11%, it had its best one day improvement in about 2 years. And included within the better numbers were cloud revenue figures that rose by 25% over the course of the last quarter, up to $5.1 billion. So that was a lot better than what the market was looking at. And that was one of the factors that helped boost the technology space last night. Industrial names also doing reasonably well. So you had 3M shares do quite nicely. They've got a new CEO over there that was announced in the last day. Elsewhere, Amazon shares were up by about 2%. Walmart shares up by about 1%. The counterpoint to that being the performance of airline stocks. So Boeing, a lot of question marks over the safety of its planes. That was reflected in commentary from the regulator last night. But what this means now, the second order impact of this is because of the challenges that Boeing are having, that is going to delay the schedules for delivery when it comes to planes. And Southwest Airlines highlighted that last night, saying that they're going to take delivery of fewer planes. planes. That's going to mean that they're going to readjust their earnings outlook. They did just that. That's part of the reason why Southwest Airlines were one of the worst performers last night, down by about 15%. So the other interesting aspect of last night's performance was the bump higher for US interest rates, not by much, a handful of points for both 2- and 10-year government bonds. So given the fact that these inflation numbers were hotter at the headline and a core level, you could have reasonably thought that those interest rate markets would have been bumping a little bit higher, but they didn't. So I suppose the point to make is that over the course of the next couple of days, you would just watch to see how these markets perform after these figures settle within investor thinking. The probability of a rate cut in June has come down a little bit, but it's still in the order of around that 60 to 70% mark. So it's still quite elevated, but that's really one of the important things that you need to look at, is how those probabilities shift following important events like the inflation numbers that we've had just last night. So quickly, as far as the European markets are concerned, we saw markets do reasonably well there. The UK market up by 1%, French market up 0.8%, the German market up 1.2%. The Stock 600 index was up by about 1%. What you tended to see in European trade was banks do quite well, obviously technology names equally well, and car makers doing quite well. So Porsche delivered better than expected earnings numbers. The stock was up by 12%. They've spoken about the challenges that were weighing on their margins. That seems to have passed. The only question is the outlook. That was a little bit weak from the market's perspective. But they've got new models coming out as far as the back end of the year is concerned, and that is encouraging investors. But just interesting to note, you know, Porsche shares are now up by 12% in year-to-date terms, so they're certainly lagging Ferrari, which has had its shares up by about 20%. So it's certainly lagging Ferrari, whose shares are up by 27% in year-to-date terms. And elsewhere, you've got BMW shares up by about 9% in year-to-date terms, and Mercedes up by about 17%. Just as an FYI, or something that you might mention over the dinner table to make you appear well-informed. But regardless, we've got the local share market, as I said, only anticipating small gains today because of the fact that we don't have that horsepower associated with the technology sector to drive us higher the way that the US markets were able to advance overnight. And in fact, again, we continue to be bedeviled by moderating commodity prices. There was a bump higher for the US dollar last night. It wasn't enduring, but we've still got downward pressure on commodity prices broadly. Gold retreating from record highs, down by more than 1% last night. You had oil prices down by around 0.75% last night. Even though OPEC is talking up its demand prospects, last night you actually had the US say that they're going to produce more energy over the course of the next 12 months, which was, I suppose, a cancelling factor in that regard. The Aussie dollar, which tried to march higher last night, getting as high as 66.4 US cents, has pulled back a little bit, so it's trading just north of 66 US cents. Have a great day. I'll talk to you again tomorrow.